Alrighty guys, welcome back to some more custom zombies and what at war. Today I'm playing a map called Rust, which is based off of the Modern Warfare 2 multiplayer map, which most of you guys should be familiar with this map. This was like one of the most popular maps in Modern Warfare 2, so now it's in zombies. So can't wait to try this map out. It does have a Bible ending, so hopefully we'll be able to beat it. And we got these buried zombies as well. I don't know why, but I love the buried zombies. They're like one of the coolest zombie models. Don't know why, but yep. So I'm pretty sure this is a box map, but hopefully it'll be pretty fun. We do got quick revive over there. We got speed cola right here. It's also got the Black Ops 3 perk machine models, which I love these models. Except for Who's Who, obviously, because Who's Who is not a Black Ops 3 perk yet. It could be a Black Ops 3 perk. But if they do bring it back, Who's Who, they do need to get rid of all the problems that people are having. Mainly spawning you in stupid areas with just a pistol and no perks on round 25 in the middle of a lot of zombies. That was the main problem I had with the perk. So, hopefully they do bring back Who's Who, if they ever do. Hopefully they fix some of the problems. And then it could be a really good perk. Because I like the theme of the perk. Going down and then reviving yourself as a ghost. Or going down, coming back as a ghost, and then reviving yourself. I love that, but I do not like being revived in the middle of a zombie horde with just your stun pistol. And no perks. Yeah, I did really like that aspect of the perk. But other than that, the perk was alright, I guess. Okay, so... Oh, I thought this gun had 45 bullets in the clip. But no, it's called the USP Tactical 45. It's actually got 12 bullets in the clip. I was like, dang, 45 bullets in the clip? This is a pretty OP pistol, but nope. Sadly not. The M240, nice. Nice little LMG to start it off with. To start our box luck off with. So can we actually open this door? No, we cannot. So yeah, I'm pretty sure there's no doors to actually open on this map. Oh, Widow's Wine. I was wondering what that jingle was. But that's the Widow's Wine jingle. Cost 3,000. I hear Mule Kick. Oh, there it is. Ain't nobody got time for Mule Kick, though. One of the worst perks in zombies. I mean, Mule Kick's an interesting one. A lot of people don't like Mule Kick, and a lot of people love it. But I'm one of the people who do not like Mule Kick. I hate it with a passion. Mainly because I hate having three weapons. Because if you are trying to switch to a weapon, having three weapons will really mess you up because you'll switch to a weapon that you did not want to switch to and then you'll wind up going down. Oh, double tap, nice. Where the heck is Jug at though? Can we actually get up here? No, we can't. So yeah, where's Jug at, I wonder? I think I've seen all the perks besides Jug. That's a lie. I probably haven't seen all the perks. Is Jug back here? It has to be back here. No, it's not. Okay. I was about to say it has to be back there in like a corner. Hidden from everybody. But nope, it's not back there, sadly. Okay. Is it actually up here, though? Like, I have a feeling Jug is in a secret spot. Secret location. On the Rust. Okay. Oh, PhD. Now, see, that would be a good spot to hide Jug. Because not too many people would have checked that. But yet, he hides PhD, though. So, there's Pack-a-Punch. So, where the heck is Jug at? Jug has to be around here somewhere. Is it back here, maybe? No, it's not. Is there any, like, other secret areas that could be holding a perk? captive. Okay, you can open that door. Yeah, where the heck is Jug? There's Deadshot over there. The heck was that music I just heard? Heard like drums or something. Oh, there's a drop over there. Wonder where it is. Let's go find out. What are you? Nuke. No, thank you. I do not want the nuke. So, hopefully you guys enjoyed my Black Ops 3... Oh, jeez. My Black Ops 3 Shadows of Evil first attempt. And if you guys did not watch it, then you guys would know. But I have a new computer now. So, it plays World at War a lot better. Black Ops 3 a lot better. And pretty awesome. And also, the render times are amazing on this PC. Like, whenever I go to render video on my old PC, it would take about 2 hours to render out like a 20-minute video. But the Shadows of Evil Part 1, I believe, was like 25 minutes. And it only took like 40 minutes as well. So, definitely loving the upload or the render time. This PC has been amazing so far. Absolutely love it. I still do not know what Jug is. Like, can we get up? Oh, we can get up here. I tried to get up here before and it wouldn't let me. Like, where the heck is Jug at? Okay, so... Oh, you gotta go down there to climb up the ladder. I haven't even heard, like, the Jug jingle or anything. So, I don't know where Jug's at. Maybe Jug's not even on the map. Oh! There it is. Okay, so that was a pretty sneaky spot for Juggernog. Come on, give me my points. There we go. I got 7,000 points as well. Now, where was Speedcaller at? Speedcaller was somewhere. I can already pack a punch if I were to. But I think I'm gonna hold off on pack-a-punching. Let's just see what weapon we can get. Ooh, a pistol. The 44 Magnum. Ooh, one bullet kill right now. Pretty nice. Pretty nice, but won't be good for points. Will not be good for points, so might as well use this M240. Oh, jeez. How you doing, buddy? Okay, yeah, I desperately need speed. But I can't remember where it was. And where's the Bible ending at as well? I'm pretty sure I read that there was a Bible ending on the map. So it should be somewhere. Okay, I'm out of M240 ammo. Is Speedcaller over this way somewhere? Oh, one. Better go ahead and get Quick Revive, though, before I forget. There it is. There's Speedcaller. There's that drums again. Is that the round change music that's making that? I believe so. Seems to happen after every round, so guessing it's the round change music. This Magnum's pretty good, though. Shotgun? No, thank you. I'll just keep my Magnum. I'll just keep my OP Magnum, which now I have insta-kill on it, so it's even more OP. The knife in Abyss though. Don't know if I like that too much. Okay, you cannot freaking hipfire with this weapon, apparently. Because it's not that accurate. Well, now it is. But somehow I missed that one zombie like 50 times. There we go. So yeah, where's our Bible ending at? Is it this thing? No, but you can mentor on that for whatever reason. Go ahead and get stamina up, because why not? There's no four perk limit, so that's nice. Always like being able to buy all the perks. Not having to worry about what perks I want to get and stuff with the 4 perk limit. This Magnum's OP though. I know that much. Oh, crap. Okay, good. You can go under that. I was like, I hope that's not clipped. But luckily it wasn't, so you could go under. Don't know what that zombie was doing. He felt like jumping on that building for whatever reason. Holy crap, this magnum's awesome. Pretty fun to use as well. So everybody be on the lookout for anything viable-ly. Viable-endedly. Look for anything that looks like it could be the Bible ending, is what I'm really trying to say. So I've got double tap. Where are the perks do I not have? I do have stamina up. I was about to say I don't have any of the Black Ops 1 perks, but I do have stamina. Might as well get Electric Cherry. Nice, I got max ammo, so now I can reload my M240. I keep on wanting to call it an M249 for some reason. Don't know why, but that's what's happening. Oh, I don't have enough for Widow's Wine. Do not have enough for Widow's Wine yet. Come on, reload faster. Okay, now I got enough for Widow's Wine. So I'm all gonna buy it in just a second. Buy it now. Buy it now. Okay. There we go. So I need to get Who's Who now. I'm probably going to skip Mule Kick because can't be bothered buying Mule Kick. I hate the perk too much to want to buy it. So yeah, where's our Bible ending at? This pistol's still a one bullet kill. Pretty OP if you ask me. It's not even pack-a-punched yet. And it's just one tapping all these zombies. I hope they can't like jump up behind me. I don't think they can. I don't think the zombies has that much skill, but apparently they do. I assume they jumped up though. Holy crap, Widow's Wine saved me. Okay, hit the box. Go ahead and kill you. Holy crap. What are you? Oh, the Model 1887. Nice. Good MW2 weapon for an MW2 map. Pretty sure the Magnum was a MW2 weapon as well. So yeah, where's our Bible ending at then? I can't find anything that would like stick out and say, hey, come here to end the map. I can't find anything like that. Crap. Model's not too bad, but I kind of want my Magnum back. The Magnum was pretty fun to use for a while. Wait, what is that sticking out? That's nothing? Oh, jeez. Widow's Wine, save me! Widow's Wine for the win. Wait, I think I just saw something over there by that gate. It could have been the Bible ending. I thought I saw a drop, but I guess not. I guess I did not see a drop at all. Okay, so are you anything? Oh, there we go. 65,000 to win the game. So there's our Bible ending. Just need to try and save up 65,000. Should be too difficult. So I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 perks. 9 perks. So what perks do I not have besides Mule Kick? And leave down in the comment section, do you guys like Mule Kick or do you guys not like Mule Kick? Because I think the zombies community is like 50-50 on Mule Kick. 50% of the players like it and 50% of the players hate it. But let me know what you guys think about Mule Kick. Do you guys like it? Hate it? Don't really have an opinion on it? Let me know. I'm curious to find out. Okay, end of round maybe? I think I'm gonna pack a punch. Oh, how did you not die? I think I'm gonna pack a punch the M240. See what it turns into. Shredding the Gnaw. Okay then. Got a nice little sight on it. Red dot sight. Ooh. The F2000. So this has some pretty good selection of weapons. Mostly for Modern Warfare 2. Which makes sense with there being a Modern Warfare 2 remake. Widow's Wine for the win. I love Widow's Wine though. Such a nice perk. Such a lifesaver as well. Oh, there's a drop there. Or not. Don't know what that was. This F2000 not too bad. All the weapons seem pretty OP on this map. Oh, these are the spiders from the Widow's Wine. Okay, makes sense now. Why I kept on thinking that there was a drop. Well, I'm already at 10,000. Holy crap. I just pack-a-punched as well. So it should really take too long to get the Bible ending. Holy crap, this weapon has a lot of ammo in it. And a sick fire rate as well. Pretty sick. I might as well use the F2000 to build up some points. Because why not? I may pack a bunch of this as well. Before I end the map. Just to see what it turns into. Oh, I'm out of ammo in it. Oh, max ammo. Nice. Just what I needed. Just what the doctor ordered. Another spider, nice. Yeah, this F2000 is pretty OP. Maybe it's just double tap making all the weapons OP. Cause some maps double tap is extremely OP, and it makes all the weapons extremely OP as well. So maybe that's what's going on. Okay, I wish there was a bank that could get interest so I could get this Bible ending quicker. But I don't think there is one. I haven't seen one at least. Could be one hiding in the shadows or somewhere. The Belgium Blue Waffles. Camo looks pretty nice as well on all the guns. Is it the same camo? Yeah, it's pretty much the same camo. Nice. Looks pretty nice. Not too bad. So now, I think I got all the perks, and now it's just saving up 65,000 for the Bible ending. And try not to die in the meantime. That may help as well. Try not to die. Doing a pretty good job, though. With these OP guns. Give me Mule Kick. I mean, not Mule Kick, what am I on about? Give me the nuke. I'm probably never going to say give me Mule Kick again in a sentence. Ever. Like that was my first time saying it. And that'll be my last time saying it. I don't know where I got Mule Kick from though. No clue where I got Mule Kick from. And there's no Wonder Fizz either, so I can't like hit it to see if I could get any secret perks that are not on the map. Yeah, this gun is just tearing them to shreds right now. Might as well throw a couple of grenades. Oh jeez, I'm out of grenades already. Thought I had more than that. Give me a nuke. Okay, 26,000, so we are slowly getting though. I wonder if you can double pack-a-punch. Nope. You cannot double pack-a-punch on this map, sadly. Ooh, insta-kill, nice. Might as well try a knife to save ammo. Hopefully I don't get like a nuke or anything. Well, I don't even need to knife. My Widow's Wine would kill them for me. Without me even having to do anything. Although it does have a cooldown, so maybe I do need to do something. What's that? Oh, double points, nice. That would definitely help to get 65,000 a lot quicker. Knife. Okay, insta-kill is out now, so I need to be careful. Although I do got an OP gun like this, holy crap. Maybe not so OP. Maybe not so OP. Okay, well, I survived somehow. Yeah, they all came out of nowhere right there, though. was not prepared for that. So yeah, 65,000. I had to make sure I didn't like misread it or anything. But yep, it is 65,000, so I'm 30,000 away from it. Should get there pretty quickly. Seems like it's pretty easy to build a point on this map though. Oh crap, get away from me zombies. Stay back, hopefully they don't spawn behind me. And just like completely wreck me. Which it doesn't even seem like they spawn behind me, so this is a pretty good camp spot. Pretty good camp spot indeed. Unless like they do spawn back there, but it's just like super rare that they do. I think I'm gonna hit the box and see what else we can get out of the box. Ooh, another LMG. The MG4. So we got two LMGs right now. Super OP. Get away from me. Nuke, no thank you. I need points. I do not need the nuke. Come on, reload. Reload faster. I need like speed color 2.0 on these LMGs. Just so I can reload a little bit faster. Insta-kill, thank you. Holy crap, everything's just happening right now. Oh jeez, I can't move. Oh no. Not like this. Oh, how am I still alive? Holy crap, Widow's Wine's OP. Assuming that was all Widow's Wine and I did absolutely nothing. Like I was just panic shooting. I was just panic shooting and just shooting around in circles. And then somehow they all died, so thinking it's mostly my Widow's Wine. 48,000. We are almost there. 18,000 away. No, 17,000 away. Yeah, 17,000. My math is no good. My math is suck. Come on, zombies. Oh, double points. Nice. That will help. Oh, jeez. Okay. Maybe I should start using this gun. The pack-a-punch weapon. Because the MG4 is no good. MG4 is no good. Well, I need 10,000 more. I could actually get enough this round. If I take mad advantage of these double points. Come on. Yeah, I could get enough. I need 5,000 more. Come on, reload. No, I don't think I will. I think we're coming to the end of the round. Yeah. So I'll definitely get enough this round, though. Might as well pack a punch the MG4. Because why not? So what are you going to turn into? Go ahead and reload this. Well, I wait. The Brock Obeat. It's got a sidearm as well. It does not have the crazy fire rate like the other LMG does though. The M240 or whatever it's called. But it's still pretty good. Can you like get away from me? Thank you. Insta-kill. Might as well take it. Oh, no. Not an insta-kill. What am I talking about? It's a max ammo. It's a max ammo that's shaped like an insta-kill, apparently. According to my logic. Nuke, go ahead and grab it. Because now I got enough to end the map. Is that going to end the round? And it does. So let's go ahead and wait till it hits 22. And then we're in the map. Unless something happens. Like a cool twist to the ending. Nope. Game over. You survived 22 rounds. So hopefully you guys enjoyed. If you did, be sure to drop a like. Really do appreciate all the support you guys give me. And subscribe if you're new. And I'll speak to you guys next time. Peace out.